Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and I had a subscriber ask me a question in a video that I did yesterday. They asked me, would training without a belt make your core stronger? Alright, so I'm going to try to answer that question. So you guys sit down, strap in, buckle up. I'm going to put on my plus five hat of weaponsmithing and work on some crafting and see if we can answer this. Alright, what I want to state up front is that this is just my opinion. My educated opinion, but this is my opinion. This is a very controversial topic among coaches, among experts in exercise science, and among top-level powerlifters. This is a major point of contention. Who's right or wrong? I don't know. I can only give you what I believe and what my observations are. There's going to be coaches who agree with me, top coaches who agree with me, and there's going to be top coaches who think I'm wrong. Who's right? But I'm going to give you my breakdown on it. I believe that, yes, you get better overall core strength and core development without a belt. Now, the counter argument is often made that EMG studies show more core activation with a belt. The problem with that is that EMG studies themselves are just not accurate enough to determine that. That's a bit of a misconception, and it's often a misuse of EMG studies. When they take two exercises that really engage a muscle seriously, and they try to use EMG studies to determine which one is better across the board, they're not accurate enough to do that. Their margin of error is like easily 20 to 30%. So, you know, if you show that something is 10% better than something else in one or two individuals on an EMG study, that's not good enough to actually call that proof. So that's part of the problem. Number two, you're talking about just surface readings and trying to make this work with a belt on. You're not putting muscle biopsy needles on and then strapping a belt over. You're just taking surface readings, guys. Again, that's simply not good enough. And the problem with that is that even if it was, you've got specificity of training. And when you observe in the real world what really happens, even if it's giving more engagement of the muscle fibers with a belt on, those muscle fibers don't seem to engage the same without the belt, even if you've built a high level of strength. And what do I mean by that? All right, you take two guys who have a 500-pound squat with a belt on. That's what they hit in competition. One of them spends most of his year training without a belt. The other one trains exclusively with a belt. Anything over about 300 pounds, he throws a belt on. Who's stronger when you take the belt off? Because, you know, according to what these people are saying, who say it gives you more core engagement, more core development, if they're right, when you take the belt off, the guy should have just as strong, if not a stronger core than the guy who trains without a belt. In fact, in theory, his core should be stronger. But it's not the case. The guy who trains year-round without a belt and only puts it on a peak for a powerlifting meet can usually still squat 450 without the belt. The guy who never squats over 300 beltless, when you take the belt off, his 500-pound belted squat, he's lucky to get 350 or 365. In fact, you'll see guys who can squat 500 with a belt. You try to put 400 pounds on them without one. If they've never trained over about 300 without a belt on, they tend to double over. They can't handle it. They can't stay upright. Their core can't actually handle the weight. So their core is still strong, and that's the thing. They're not just like a weakling, because, I mean, if you can squat 350 without a belt, the average person walking around on the street who just exercises a little bit can't do that. Their core is not strong enough to do that. So you still have a strong core, but it's nowhere near as strong as a guy who trained without the belt once the belt is off. Now, the argument could be made, well, if the guys compete with a belt, why does it matter how strong they are without a belt? Because it's still about core strength. And while there might be some truth to that, there are plenty of serious top-level powerlifters who train with a belt year-round. There's also plenty of world champions who do not. Dan Green advocates training up to half the year without a belt. He himself did it the entire time. He was a world record holder, and I believe he still is, in the 242 raw class, raw powerlifting world record holder. When Jamie Lewis was the 181 raw powerlifting world record holder, he trained almost the entire year without a belt, and he still deadlifted without a belt. KK, the Latvian raw deadlift world record holder, deadlifts in comp without a belt. He doesn't even wear a belt to set his world records. So what does that tell you about the core strength of these guys? These guys are the best, and they're advocating it. That might not be the only secret they have, of course. I mean, meaning just because someone's a world champion doesn't mean that all their methods are actually good. But there is definitely a pattern there. You've got multiple guys who are world record holders, at least one of which coaches at a serious level. And they all advocate it when there's multiples of them and they're beating guys who do it the other way. There might be something to their method. Furthermore, all your Olympic lifters, they train without a belt year round. If it made their core stronger to do, say, their squatting with a belt, don't you think they would all be squatting with belts? Guys who are winning the gold medals, they would be squatting with belts because it would make their core stronger and it would carry over to their other lifts, and they might be able to, you know, clean and jerk 2 more kilos as a result of it. But they don't do it that way because it doesn't seem to. They don't need it, and therefore there's no point in it. So my other point there is that, all right, fine, if you compete with a belt in some sport, that's fine. But what about all these people who just want to be strong and fit? What role does a belt have for them? It doesn't. I think it gives you a weaker core when you don't have the belt on. When you get in any sort of other lift that you need to do, that you can't wear a belt, you're not going to get the same carryover as if you train without a belt all the time. What happens when you need to do something in an emergency? You need to pull something heavy off of someone. And you don't have as strong of a core as if you had trained without a belt. It's going to be harder for you to do. What about if you get kicked or hit in the stomach? You're not going to have as strong of a core. And this carries over to MMA fighters, NFL players, things like that, football players, rugby players, people who get hit in the gut in their competition. I would really recommend they train without a belt so they'll have a stronger core because they don't have a belt on when they take that hit in the gut. And the same applies for you. It's no more difficult or time-consuming for you to get in the gym and train without a belt. Since you don't compete in anything that allows you to wear a belt, it's the same amount of time and effort to train without one. What happens if you actually need to demonstrate your strength or take a hit in the gut or whatever? You've lost nothing by training without a belt. But if you train with a belt, you're going to take a hit in the gut harder. You're going to be able to flex less to protect yourself. It's going to be less useful. You're going to have less strength without the belt when you have to pick something up in an emergency. And I'm not saying these things are going to happen. Many of you who lift are never going to get hit in the gut with anything, with a foot, with a hip, with a car. Many of you are never going to be in an emergency where you have to pick something up heavy to where your life or someone else's life depends on it. But what if it does? What's the point of lifting weights and doing all this stuff if when these things do occur, if they do occur, that you're not able to perform with them optimally? It's like, what's the point? The only reason for wearing a belt is because you want a fashion accessory and you want to be able to lift 10 or 20 more pounds to impress people on your squat. Or you just want, again, to spend $100 on a fashion accessory to wear around the gym. You're actually better off 100% of the time training without a belt unless you compete in something that allows you to utilize the belt to lift more weight. So anyone who's not a competitive power lifter or a competitive strongman who trains with a belt, I think it's pointless. I don't think there's any benefit to it. I think you're wasting your time. And you could have a stronger overall core if you just skip the belt. But you know what, guys? At the end of the day, that's just my opinion. I'm not stating the fact that a stronger core is my opinion, but as to whether you should do that or not is my opinion. And ultimately, all of you can decide for yourselves what you want to do. I mean, if you want to spend $100 on a nice belt and have a fashion accessory at the gym, if that makes you happy, then by all means, continue to do it. But what I'm advocating is that for the same amount of work and for $100 less, you could have a stronger core if you just skipped using the belt. All right, guys, well, that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.